Okay, student. I am Bilal Khan from Data Science Center. In previous tutorial, we discussed entity relationship model, the concept of entity, entity type, entity instance, and entity set. Today, we will discuss the types of entity type. So, entity type has the two different types. And you see that entity type is the collection of entities that share the common properties or characteristics. That is the entity types. So entity type has the two further types. One is strong entity and weak entity. When we see that we are having concept of strong entity, entity type that exists independently of another entity type. Like that we are having entity type that exists independently of another entity type that is called strong entity type. Entity type whose instance can exist independently, like we are having imply, that is a strong entity type that can exist independently. Right? Instance of this one entity imply can exist independently. We can represent strong entity type using the rectangle or box in the name of entity type must be enclosed within a box. Ali is imply. So if he is imply, we can store the data of imply. Mth imply, Rafi imply, and we can simply store the data of that imply. Whenever we have strong entity type, that have their own identity. That's why we say that they have identifier that can uniquely identify the record of strong entity type. That is called identifying owners. That is a strong entity type. Mean entity type that exists independently of another entity type. That is a strong entity type. And weak entity type whose existence depends on another entity type. That is called weak entity type. The instance of weak entity type cannot exist without being linked with the instance of some other entity type. Weak entity type have no business meanings in ER diagram without the entity type on which it depends. Like, we see that whenever we are having strong entity type, for that one we see that it have its own identifier. But that can uniquely identify. But when we see that we are having weak entity type, that have a partial identifiers. Means we can identify it weak entity using the partial identifier of the strong entity as well as the weak entity. How we can represent it? Strong entity can be represented by rectangles and the name of entity type enclosed within a rectangle. Weak entity type can be represented by double line rectangles in the name of this one. So strong entity type we say that imply, it is strong entity type, and weak entity type dependent. So dependent of any implies, we say that instance of strong entity type can exist independently. But we say that whenever we are having instance of weak entity type, they can't exist independently without being linked with the instance of some other entity type. So instance of dependent entity type can't exist. Right? Ali is imply. If Ali has mother, father, wife, kids, so they can be exist whenever Ali is imply. If Ali is not imply, so instance of weak entity type can't exist independently without being linked with the some other entity type. That's why we see that to represent the weak entity type, we are having the partial identifier. To represent the strong entity type, we are having the identifier. To represent the weak entity type, we are having the partial identifier. So here, imply, that is a strong entity type, having its own identifier. We can represent the identifier by underlining it. Imply ID is the identifier of the strong entity type. And here, we see that dependent, that is a weak entity types, and having the identifier, that is a dependent names, the identifier of the vehicle type that must be double underlines. That is a partial identifier. And whenever we are having the relationship between instrument type and vehicle type, that relationship is called identifying relationships. So here we are having the relationship, this one relationship. So that is identifying relationship. Relationship between strong entity type and weak entity type, that is called identifying relationship. One term that is very important, that we say identifying owner. The entity type on which weak entity type is dependent is called identifying owners. So here we are having employee entity on this one vehicle type that dependent. So that is employee is called identifying owners, because on this employee entry type and other vehicle type depend, that's why this one is called identifying owners. Thanks for watching my video.